Hello, good morning children. How are you? Hope all of are fine and happy. Yes, today we are going to read about nouns. I know that earlier you have learned about nouns, but still let us recap once again, okay? Noun is a name of a person, place, animal or thing. Noun is a name. Name यानी किसी का भी नाम, any name. Maybe my name, your school name, your house name, your book name, any name. Place. It may be your place, your kitchen. It is also a place. Garden, school. It is also a place. Any auditorium. Animal name. Any cat, bat, rat, cow. All the animals and the things. Your mouse, your mobile, your pen, your copy, all these things are nouns. So let us know ki why do we need to learn noun in English language. Hame kyon zarurat padti hai English language mein noun language ki. Suppose there is a boy whose name is Arun. He wants to buy some stationery items. Suppose usse kuch stationery items khareedne hai. To what he will say to the shopkeeper? He will say, give me two pens, give me two pencils, one copy. So all these items, whatever he needs, are called noun. उसने जितनी भी चीजें कही हैं, उसने pen मांगा, copy, तो all these things are noun.
How many kinds of nouns are there? There are five kinds of noun. First is proper noun. Proper nouns are the specific names of people, places, countries, cities, rivers, mountains, historical places, and you may say festivals, days of the week. All are counted in proper noun. Days of the week, Wednesday, Tuesday, Monday. Building name, Taj Mahal, and you may say Lal Qila. Particular person name, suppose the name of your school principal, the name of the school prime minister of country. So these are particular name. Aapka khud ka naam bhi, that is also counted as a proper noun. Okay. Now the rivers, you see Ganga, Nile, Thames and Yamuna, all are counted in proper noun, which are having a special name. Okay. And these proper nouns are always written in capital letter. Now come to the common noun. Common nouns are the names given to ordinary objects, places, things, etc. किसी भी कोई भी common चीज जो होती है general, like boy, men, hospital, book, so many things are there which are common. Okay. A student, it is also a common noun. Your book. Okay. Now come the collective noun. Collective nouns are the collection of things. किसी भी चीज का जो कलेक्शन होता है, इट इज द यू मे से दैट द कलेक्शन ऑफ पीपल, एनिमल, थिंग्स, दे आर टेकन टुगेदर एंड स्पोकन एज अ होल. ग्रुप ऑफ सिमिलर पर्संस, प्लेसेस, लाइक पैक, हर्ड, आर्मी, स्वार्म ऑफ बीज. समटाइम्स वी से दैट बैंड ऑफ म्यूजिशियन. समटाइम्स वी से अ टीम ऑफ प्लेयर्स. Pile of books, herd of animals, all are counted as a collective noun. When a group of animals are there, we use a herd of animals. Material noun. Material nouns, some substances, some material like wood, silver, gold, and etc. बहुत सारी जो material noun things होती हैं, these are counted as a material noun. इसमें glass है आपका, fiber है. These are also counted as material noun. Now come to the abstract noun. Abstract noun is the name of some quality, state of mind, feeling, idea, emotion that we can only think or feel. जिसे हम केवल सोच सकते हैं और feel कर सकते हैं, but we cannot touch or see. ना तो हम उसको देख सकते हैं, ना touch कर सकते हैं. That is abstract noun, like wisdom, bravery, poverty, fear. Suppose there is a beautiful girl in your class. So we can feel only the beauty of that girl. We cannot touch the beauty of the girl. हम उस girl की beauty को touch नहीं कर सकते. We can only feel it. Now let us come to the countable and uncountable nouns. There are some nouns that can be counted. बहुत सारे noun होते हैं जिन्हें हम count कर सकते हैं. Most of the common and collective nouns are countable. Common and collective nouns. Although collective noun also used in their singular form as well as in their plural form. It means collective noun को कभी तो हम singular form में use करते हैं, कभी उनको plural form में. Okay? Like river, books, man, bed. All these are common noun. In my last slide, I taught you. These are the common word, river, books, man and bags. But in my next example, I bought a bunch of bananas. I bought a bunch of banana. Here the bunch is a collective noun. So I have used here the singular form of the collective noun. In the next sentence, please get two bunches of bananas. In this sentence, I have used the plural form of collective noun. यहाँ पे plural form use की है. It means collective nouns can also used in the singular forms as well as in the plural forms. One more rule that mostly proper, abstract and material nouns are uncountable. It means there are five kinds of noun. Proper noun, that is uncountable. Second, common, it is countable. Third is collective, it is countable. And sometimes used in singular and plural form. And abstract material, these are uncountable. These three we do not use the we do not count them. Like Taj Mahal, proper noun, we do not count them. Count it. Wisdom, it is an abstract noun. We do not count it. Material noun, gold, silver, we do not count them. These are uncountable nouns. Countable nouns has singular and plural form, and we use an, few, many, etc. with singular and plural forms. Like sometimes we say an army, sometimes we say many birds, few chairs, two cakes, a dozen oranges. It means we use these words with singular as well as with plural forms. But these words are used with countable noun. And in my next sentence, listen, with uncountable nouns, जिनको हम count नहीं कर सकते, तो उनके साथ हम use करते हैं little, some, much, many. Like, give me some milk. There is little water in the jug. Students are making too much noise. Much noise, okay? Many girls. तो where we cannot count, बहुत सारी चीजें हैं, but we cannot count them. तो we use some. Little, much, many. In English language, a noun may be either in singular and plural form. Okay, singular and plural form. But how to convert them in singular form and how to convert them in plural form? Okay, now let us study. Sometimes we add only a single S to make the singular noun in a plural form. Like dog is a singular. We add just S here to make it plural. Table is a singular noun. I have added here only S to make it plural form. Okay. The first rule is to add S only. Sometimes we add ES to make them plural. But where we add ES? We add when the noun is ending in S, double S, SH, CH, O and X. When a noun is ending in these words, okay, then we add es in the end of the word. At the end of the word, we last me es laga dete hain to make it plural. Like box, it is ending in x. Aap dekhiye x mein end ho raha hai. I have added es. Match, ch is there. I have added here es. Okay, and the next rule is. When a word and when a singular noun is ending in y, we convert this y into ies. Like baby, y is there. I removed y and add ies in place of y. Family, y is there. remove y and add ies in place of y. Lady, remove this y and add ies. It will be counted as plural noun. Babies, families and ladies. Now come to the next rule, that is ves. If a singular noun is ending in f or fe, यदि कोई singular noun f or fe में end हो रहा है, तो we will convert this f into ves. हम उस f की जगह use करते हैं ves. Let us see the example. Calf, c a l f. Remove f and add ves. Life, it is ending in fe. Remove fe and add ves to make it plural form. Okay, but there are some exceptions are also here. Let us read them. Suppose there is a word that is ending in y in the end. Okay, last mein y mein end ho raha hai, but listen carefully, but if there is a vowel before y, yadi y se pehle koi vowel hai before it, so we will add only s instead of ies. Hum usme s jodenge, ies nahi, because there is a vowel before y, y se pehle vowel hai. Now let us see another example. Journey, here is a e before y, e is a vowel, so we will add only s instead of ies. Boy, again vowel is before y, y se pehle vowel aa raha hai, so we will add only s. Okay, so these are another rule. Now come to the next rule. I taught you that if the word is ending in f or fe, we will use only ves. Okay, but if there is a vowel before f, agar aapke f se pehle koi vowel hai, we will add only s, not ves. Again, chief, f is there, it is ending in f, but there is a vowel before f, we will add only s, not ves. Okay, there are some other rules, that some nouns are there who do not follow any above rules. ये जो रूल्स हैं, दे डू नॉट फॉलो, उनका अपना रूल चलता है. लाइक चाइल्ड का, चिल्ड्रन, वोमेन, वोमेन, देयर इज नो रूल. इनके लिए कोई रूल नहीं है कि क्यों हमने यू है. बस माउस का माइस, ऑक्स का ऑक्सन, गूस का गीज. ओके, लेट अस रीड सम मोर रूल्स. देयर आर सम नाउन्स आर हियर हु आर सेम इन सिंगुलर एंड प्लुरल, हु आर अलाइक. नाउ शीप, the plural of sheep is sheep. Pear ka pear, fish ka fish, no plural. These are alike, singular plural are same. But one more rule, that few nouns are treated as plural. Like paired item, jiska pair hota hai, group, jise aapka scissors hote hain, aapki kaichi, it has two legs, so it will be counted as plural. Wo singular count nahi hogi, although s is here. ओके, तो वो दे विल ट्रीट एज अ उनका सिंगुलर नहीं होता. टोंग्स यानी चिमटा, टू लेग्स आर देयर. ट्राउजर्स, टू लेग्स आर देयर. जीन्स, टू लेग्स आर देयर. शॉर्ट्स, ग्लासेस, पैंट. हियर ग्लासेस, कौन से ग्लासेस है? नॉट फॉर ड्रिंकिंग वाटर, दिस ग्लासेस मीन्स चश्मा होता है ना, तो दीज आर ऑल्सो ग्लासेस, दे आर कॉल्ड ग्लासेस. तो एस इज देयर, but there is no singular form of these paired word. Inke koi bhi singular nahi hota, they are treated as plural. And one more thing, some subjects like mathematics, physics, economics, inme dekhiye sab mein s laga hua hai. S, mathematics, physics, s laga hua hai. And economics, here is s here. And politics hota hai, unme bhi s hota hai, but they are counted as singular, not plural. डिजीज, मीजल्स, मम्स, जो डिजीज इनमें देखिए वो लगा हुआ है एस. एंड ट्यूबरकुलोसिस, रिकेट्स, सब में ऐसे. एंड लाइक गेम्स, बिलियर्ड्स गेम्स, इसमें भी ऐसे आर प्लूरल, दे आर लुकिंग प्लूरल बट यूज्ड एज सिंगुलर. ओके, मैथमेटिक्स इज अ डिफिकल्ट सब्जेक्ट, इसमें एस है तो इसमें आर नहीं लगाएंगे हम वर्ब में, तो दे आर काउंटेड एज सिंगुलर, नॉट प्लूरल. नाउ नेक्स्ट, Materials like paper, wood, iron, copper are used only in singular form. I already taught you that there are no plurals of these words. Okay. Next, abstract noun like love, beauty, anger are not countable. Hence, they do not have any plural form. Okay. As you know that there are four genders in English language. How many genders are there? Four genders: masculine, feminine, common, and neuter. So, what is a masculine gender? A noun which refers to a male figure, जो male figure को verify करती है, like man, father, boy, bull, lion, son, king, nephew, grandfather, uncle, all are masculine. आप ऐसे याद रखिए, M for masculine and M for male. Feminine, F for feminine and F for female. Nouns which refers to a female person, जो female को refer करते हैं, like mother, woman, girl, cow, aunt, grandmother, daughter, queen, all are feminine noun, feminine gender. Now third is common noun. So let us read what is common noun. Common gender is that which refers to a male or female person. जो male, we don't know ki whether the person is male or female. Like teacher, we can use teacher word for male and female. Doctor, for use both of them. Player, bird, cousin, person, parent, companion, announcer, child, baby, all these are counted as common noun. Okay, common gender, because they do not verify the particular person is male or female. Come to the neuter. Neuter is refer to things that are neither male nor female. Usually they refers to lifeless objects. Mostly they lifeless object use hote hain, like oven, laptop, pen, wood, chair, school, goods. These are counted as a neuter gender. Okay, I think that this is sufficient for you. You have learned a lot about nouns. Thank you. Thank you once again. Happy learning. Be at your home. Stay safe. Stay happy.